face like it be both. Dude, man, dude, isn't this beautiful? Look at this, man. We are like just rolling along Lake Michigan. Rolling along Lake Michigan. Brick to the face like you Debo. Man, I'm listening to Jim Jones, which is some, believe it or not, Jim Jones has some, he has some really good traveling music. Some really good riding music, you know? Like, if you want to have some music to listen to while you're riding along, the last album of, what's the name of that album? Capo something? I can't remember the name of that shit. But, it was just, it's just, it was, it's decent, man. It was, he got some skills. Jim Jones got some fucking skills, man. I can't say much for his thoughts on like black clothing lines and shit like that. That shit he was saying, that was some ill shit, man. I look drippy and Gucci and Versace, and why would I buy Sean John or Rockaway? Man, that's some knockoff shit. I'm like, dude, what the fuck? I couldn't believe that dude was saying that shit. Like, slay, man. You know, people tell you to hate your own shit, or people who look like you and are doing something, and you think that you're not fly or popping or whatever unless you fucking rocking some shit that Europeans are telling you to wear. It's crazy, man. That's but you know what, man? I mean, what can you really say, man? You know, people gotta, you can't make somebody think right about themselves. They have to want to see it. They have to want to have something more for themselves. You know, they have to see the value in themselves, the value in what they bring to the table. Only they can do that. That's a beautiful shot right there. I should have pulled over to the side. It's a car that's right behind me, and I really don't want to pull to the side and sort of freak the dude out, because it's like we're going at pretty decent speed. Nice clip. And the roads are wet, icy, and slowing down like that might cause something. I wanna, this dude is so beautiful out here though, man. Man, it's beautiful out here. Brick to the face like the Debo. But man, dude, it's just like, seriously though, man, the dude has some wonderful traveling music. But like I was saying though, when I saw his interview, he was talking about, man, I'm dripping, and what was that shit he was calling, talking about? Oh, dude, this is so beautiful. Look at that shit. He was saying, when I'm rocking Louis and when I'm rocking Gucci and this and that and other, blah, 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 like, your mentality. Your mentality should be, okay, yeah, Gucci doing this, Louis doing this, whoever else is doing whatever else they doing, I'm going to be the next Gucci, or I'm going to be the next Louis Vuitton. And I don't think that's what he gets. I don't think he got that message. That's what Sean John clothing line is about. That's what the Rockaway clothing line was about. That's what the Wu-Tang clothing line was about. You know, they see, hey, look, we have a brand. Our shit is popping. Let's do something for the culture. because the culture vultures are already taking from us all day long. Let's do something for ourselves and for the culture. You know, let's create something that we want versus being told what's popping. We create the culture. How you gonna tell us what's popping? You know what I'm saying? But that's enough for ranting about Jim Jones, man. Nice album. Nice album. Just his thoughts on his interview with that, about when he was talking about clothing lines and shit like that. That shit, it surprises me, because I'm like, that's the type of mentality where somebody would be like, yeah, man, I got the newest whip this year. Versus, yeah, I bought a car lot that has all the newest whips on it this year. And once I get through selling them motherfuckers, it's gonna have all the newest whips on it next year. And then the newest whips on it the year after that. And every year, I can take a car off of my lot, drive it as much as the fuck I want to, put it back on the lot for sale. And it's a business write-off. We gotta really start thinking, man. We gotta think for ourselves, man. Why the fuck are you out here? It was Don Juan, an image of him that really made me start thinking about that shit. He was talking to, I think he was having an interview with Snoop Dogg. He was talking, yeah, I had all the flies, bitches, and such. And he's talking, he got his huge ass pinky, still got his huge ass gold pinky ring on. Yeah, and such, and this and that other. Oh, man, let me show you the pictures. And he had all these pictures, man. Him in the Rolls Royces, him in the Caddies, and his gold and green colors and shit like that, all that shit. And you got memories of all that shit. That's wonderful. But all that shit is gone. Create your memories. That's a wonderful thing to do. Hell yeah. Also, create generational wealth. Create your memories. Yes. And if you want to create memories by buying shit, make sure you buying shit that's going to help you create generational wealth. Don't buy the flyest ride. I got the brand new drop top, Rolls Royce, blah 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 blah. Yeah, that's nice. 20, 30 years from now, that flyest Rolls Royce ain't gonna be worth what you think it was worth then. You know, where's that vehicle at? Why don't you buy the car lot? Put new vehicles on, like I said earlier, put new vehicles on your car lot every year. Take one of the brand new vehicles off the lot, drive it around. You got a new whip every year. You in the newest whip every year. And you throwing it right back onto your lot for sale. And you getting a tax write-off. Because you're using it for business purposes. You know what I'm saying? Shit. Man, when you start thinking about how cold we could be on this shit, where it could be, where we could go. But all we can do is show you better than we can tell you. Sometimes we need that break, man. And when we get that break, you circumvent the system and make sure you know how to, or get your thoughts together on how you're going to use that break to your advantage to create generational wealth, to create what's that shit called? When you're getting lucrative money, that's what's it called? It's not called infinity. You know what I'm talking about. When you get money from something like a house or an apartment building or something like that, you're getting monetary funding from your residual. You're getting residual funds from your whatever it is you came up with. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, man, it's just like, gotta get our minds right, baby. Gotta get our minds right. Stop living in the "I just want to spend" mentality, and start thinking about how can my children's 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 children be able to spend? How can they be able to afford? Also, like I said, you can't force people to come with you on your ride, on your journey. You know, you're building your generational wealth, and you're learning how to do it on your own. You can share it with your loved ones. You can share it with your kids. Or whoever. But that's not to say that everybody's gonna wanna hear it. You know, that everybody's gonna wanna be like, "Oh yeah, I wanna learn how to build generational wealth with you too," or "I wanna learn how to make sure that I'm set in the future, and my family is set in the future." Not everybody's gonna want to hear that. Not everybody's gonna want to do that, and that's okay. You know why it's okay? It's not everybody's meant to go on your journey. Your journey is for you, and if you happen to find people that want to go on that journey with you, more power to it, man. You know, just make sure you ain't dragging nobody on the journey. Make sure you're not fucking you have to fucking pull somebody on the journey with you. "Oh yeah, I'm gonna help you every step of the way along the journey." Nah, you gotta show fact that you want to get that, you gotta put forth your initiative too. You know, I said I was gonna buy some UP barbecue while I was up here. I actually should have stopped and get some Upper Peninsula beer while I'm up here, because I know they got your places up here too. It's just, I'm so glad to be out and about right now. I'm really looking forward to getting back on the road. And this test run that last night in the Prius was a really good thing, man. I was able to come out here where it's cold at, sleep in the vehicle, not really be too disturbed by it cutting on and off all night. Not even gonna say not be too disturbed. I was not disturbed by it cutting on and off all night. I was knocked out for a good 5 hours. I was knocked out, so it did its job. It kept me good and warm. man, it and it only used about say 9 to 10 gallons worth of gas per, I mean, not 9 to 10 gallons, 9 to 10 miles worth of gas every hour. 9 to 10 miles worth of gas every hour it used. They did a really good job, man. Really good job. I was really, really, really surprised by how well it performed overnight. Alright, so we are about to hit the this is the last chance right here to grab like a peninsula beers and shit like that. Let's see. I really, you know what, fuck that. I ain't gonna do all that shit. Normally I would, but man, I'm just not feeling it right now, so we're just gonna keep it moving. Keeping it moving. Man, dude, it looks so nice out here. It's not that, it was not this much snow on the ground last time I came out here. But also, last time I came out here, I went really deep into howdy doody. How's it going today? Alrighty. Thank you so much. Hey, you got a receipt? Thank you so much. Cool. Have a good day now. Alright. Money up. We gonna get back on this road. Stop and take a picture real quick. So excuse me for pausing real quick. Like I gotta get it. Boom. And one of the bridge, and we good to go. No. Doesn't look really that amazing, like that much of an amazing capture from this angle. But let's see what we can do with it. It's sort of, it's unique that on this side, you got no other choice but to pay to get in. But just like with all things in life, there's always a few options. Like, say for instance, you're wealthy enough to fly in. That means you don't have to pay the toll to get in, the $4 toll. And if you don't want to pay the $4 toll, you got to drive in, then you can go through Wisconsin and to come into the UP. But if you come into the UP through Michigan, oh, they gonna make you pay. You gotta pay the toll, baby. And that's why I was trying to send me the other way. I got it to where I don't normally pay tolls. And they got it to where I was supposed to go the opposite direction. So, look at this, man. Look at this beautiful, huge bridge. Oh, shit. And it's just throwing me all over the road. Man, let's get into this area. I think buses and trucks no passing, so we're gonna use this to pass. This little area is to pass, and this little area is to drive. Just throwing me all over the road. If I was on, stayed on a little metal braided part. Man, dude, this is so beautiful. There's nothing like this on the other side coming through Wisconsin. There's no huge fancy bridge to come through. Yes, that's why they got the tolls. They gotta still paying for the bridge and shit. Oh, but you know, there's a 100-year debt on that bridge. You gotta pay $4 every time you come through. Man, dude, we are. Shit, I'm going too fucking fast. God, I think it said like 45 miles an hour or some shit. Here, and it was really packed. However, I do remember being here and it being it's snowing out here though. So I think what it was I came up here twice. Like, I think they sent me up here to map the UP with Google Maps. Up here to map the UP with Google Maps. They sent me like deep into the Upper Peninsula part of the of Michigan, and it snowed. And they let me stay up there for a few days, and the snow really didn't let up like they thought it would. And it was like, all right, well, make it back to Chicago, and then we'll just go from there. And then they sent me back up here. It was like summer, got to see the wonderful part of UP. Y'all get to see the speed limits. And y'all got to hit me, chitter chatter, ramble. Maybe some of you views, maybe some of you already knew. Maybe it's something that you could share with a friend or two. By hitting the like button and hitting that, what's that thing called? Subscribe button and shit. The subscribe and the notification button. You know, I don't really say it that much because it's not like I'm really looking for anybody to subscribe or notify, get notified about what I'm talking about. I'm doing this because it's just something I feel like doing. This is my way. It's cathartic. It's a way of me being able to work on speaking more clearly, getting past the ADD thoughts and getting past the PTSD and all that good stuff. It's like, you know, as a veteran and shit like that, you gotta, as a human being, you need to work on yourself. But as a veteran, me working on my PTSD, me working on my ADHD, the manic depression shit, all this stuff that I have to work on, this is a part of it. Being able to talk, being able to hear my voice, and being able to just get it out in the universe and let it just be what it is.
Talking about anything, just